And good evening, everybody, and welcome to Basketball Night in West Hartford as we're at Robinson Gym at Hall High School. The Conard Chieftains in town to take on the Hall Warriors. High school sports on Channel 5 presented, as always, by the War Chief Sports Council. Hi again, everybody. Pete Lammer along with Coach John Beignet as we get ready for a weekend of hoops. We'll have the boys' game tomorrow afternoon at 3. First up, though, the ladies, and what a matchup it is. The Chieftains at 11-1, ranked 10th in the Hartford current state poll. The Warriors 7th in the state at 11-2. First time these teams have had 10-plus wins in their first matchup since 76-77. The similarities are amazing. Both in the top 10, both have first-year head coaches, and both teams have dynamic backcourts. And John Beignet, because of those reasons and more, what an intriguing matchup it is.
Hi, Peter. Yeah, thank you. These two teams are, again, repeating history here. Back in 76-77, Hall won that game 48-46. They finished the year with a record of 21-3, losing in the Class Double-L title game to Lee of New Haven 37-35. Conard, on the other hand, finished that year 18-3 and would eventually win the Double-L championship 2 years later. Both of these teams are really headed to a lot of postseason success as well, I think.
Yeah, absolutely. And you look at this, Conard on the one hand, with first-year head coach Mike D'Angelo, they graduated 6 kids last year, and here they are, a 17-3 team a year ago, 11-1. On the other hand, you have a first-year head coach in Brittany Huggins. They only won 7 games last year, and they're at 11-2. Amazing coaching jobs.
Yeah, Coach Huggins has done a great job. Those kids last year for Hall were on the verge of really making a step up, and they did when they, I think, beat the Chieftains at Conard last year. The Chieftains, I didn't think, would be in this situation after losing all their, remarkable players of last year, but they've done a great job and, everyone picking up a new role and playing well together.
Yeah. Look at the Conard backcourt, Peretti and Connors. What a dynamic duo they've been.
Yeah, I saw them play a week or so ago, and I just love the way they play. It's kind of my style, the way they push the ball, they run, they attack the basket, they shoot the ball. It's a lot of fun to watch.
Reisner and Gellerman, great backcourt on the other side as well.
Yeah, those girls, I think I wanted someone's autograph last year. Miss Reisner, I didn't get it. Maybe I'll get it tonight. But again, another great backcourt duo there.
Yeah, we look forward to it. Crowd is now rising as we get set for the national anthem.
Our country so that we can enjoy this evening with the singing of our national anthem by a Hall freshman, Samantha Acosta.
And a nice rendition of our national anthem just moments before the opening tip-off of tonight's game. A reminder that, again, we'll join you for boys action tomorrow afternoon, 3 o'clock tip time, right back here at Robinson Gym. Good matchup there. Brian Moretti in attendance here tonight. His Hall Warriors at 6-3 take on Jared Leghorn's Conard Chieftains, who are up to 3-7 after their most recent win last night. The War Chief Sports Council would like to thank the many fine sponsors, including those at the all-state level, Keating Insurance, MACA, Plumbing and Heating, Reed and Reach PC, Counselors at Law, ESPN, and the College Prep Express. The lineups for both teams. First for Conard, we talked about Lena Prietti and Delaney Connors in the backcourt. Up front, Tatiana St. Just along with Maggie Venora and Liz Ladd. For Hall at 11-2, Amber Reisner and Lexi Gellerman in the backcourt. Maddie Mandyke up front along with Marie Cotter and Caroline O'Keefe. Conard dressed in their traditional road red with the white trim and the white numerals. The home white uniforms for Hall with the blue trim and the blue numerals. Getting set to jump it up. It'll be Caroline O'Keefe for the Hall Warriors against St. Just, and it's controlled by Hall. Two on one, bounce pass underneath, and the first shot is missed, and it's rebounded by the Chieftains. Trouble in the backcourt, and a whistle 9 seconds in, John.
Yeah, the girls are getting right after it. One coaches might have complained that layup could have been a foul as well. Girls just got tangled up in transition there. Not much of a foul, but it was given anyway.
As a coach, do you like to have the mentality of let the kids play, or do you like a tight game call?
Well, you know, it depends. Usually at the end of the game, depending on what the score is, you have a differing opinion. But, you know, you want your kids at this early to be aggressive, and, you know, they're certainly getting after it right now.
Shot by Conard hit the top of the backboard, so possession out of bounds to Hall. Their second possession of the opening quarter. Just underway, no score, half minute gone by, opening stanza. Glad you've joined us for our high school game of the week. Ball is knocked out of bounds, and it will stay Hall possession. Both of these teams were in action last night, both posting victories, and for the respective teams, wins number 11 on the season. As we said, Hall at 11-2. Conard at 11-1. Extraordinary starts. Ball is stolen. Lead pass ahead. Shot on the way. Up and good. The first basket of the game goes to Lena Prietti. Hall tries to answer immediately, and they throw it away. Boy, you saw the terrific speed of Prietti getting ahead of the field that time, John.
Yeah, she didn't notice that breaking out. They got her to the ball. She used her body very well to screen that defender off as she made the layup.
Lena Prietti, the junior point guard, averaging 6 points, 7 assists, and 4 steals per contest. This is St. Just with the basketball, guarded by Maddie Mandyke. Back outside to Delaney Connors. What a backcourt they are. Two excellent backcourts in action here tonight. Baseline move, and a foul's going to be called. It looks like Marie Cotter is guilty of the infraction for Hall.
Yeah, nice aggressive play by Venora. Put the ball on the ground real quick. She doesn't slide and shut off that baseline quickly enough on D.
So, possession to Cotter. Inbounds pass. The shot on the way by Venora is missed, and it's rebounded by Caroline Keefe. Into the front court. Warriors setting up, trying to get on the scoreboard for the first time. Nice pass underneath. Shot off the glass and good. Amber Reisner able to connect, and she has tied the game at 2. This is St. Just in the front court for Cotter. Pass underneath. Kicking it back out. Three ball is on the way. Is short. Chasing her own rebound. Putting it up and missing it. The Conard Chieftains. And it's rebounded by Hall. Good follow by Liz Ladd that time, John, but to no avail.
Yeah, the coaches like their players to do that. Not many players do nowadays, but great job by Liz. Unfortunate the ball didn't go down.
Gellerman on the drive. She drew contact, and she'll go to the line. Lexi, been playing since her freshman year. Called by her coach the most vocal of all the Hall Warriors, and they said that's a good thing.
Well, that is a good thing. You know, I was watching a couple games earlier this week, and just the collective affect of the team that I was watching was very flat. Not a lot of emotion or energy coming from players on the court or off. And even if it's a player that's not a real contributor, if they are vocal and supportive, it makes a huge difference to the energy of the team in general.
Oh, I bet. Lexi misses both, but the rebound goes to Gellerman. Outside three is short. Rebounded by Hall. Third opportunity, and that rims the basket, and it's rebounded by Conard. So good looks by the Warriors that time. Reisner took the last shot, couldn't get it to go down. Off the fast break, Conard missing the shot, and the rebound goes to Hall. Now you talk about what a difference a year makes. These two teams played on this floor last year, and Conard won 60-19. Mm-hmm. And a year later, here are the teams very, very competitive with one another. Pass is kicked, and it will stay Hall basketball as Olivia Boney is the first substitution for the Hall Warriors as she replaces Marie Cotter. This is Maddie Mandyke, who, according to many associated with Hall basketball, is the MVP of this squad thus far. Had a 15-point, 15-assist game for herself in the victory over Plainville last Saturday. Three ball on the way from the left side. That rims the basket, and it's rebounded by Liz Ladd of Conard. Two passes later, the ball is knocked out of bounds. They're trying to find St. Just underneath, but Olivia Boney did a nice job coming back defensively.
Yeah, great hustle coming back. Venora saw her early just before she caught the ball and thought Tatiana St. Just was open, but the defender closed down really quickly and knocked that ball away.
Shot from the deep right wing is an air ball, but Conard gets the rebound for Eddie. Passes across court to Ladd. Guarded by Reisner. She drives, misses the shot, and is rebounded by Hall. This is Gellerman into the front court. Oops. Nice pass, wide open underneath, and the shot is up and good by Caroline O'Keefe.
Yeah, the Chieftains lost someone on their defensive transition down there, left someone wide open at the basket, wide open. And Tatiana's fouled as she receives another great pass from Peretti down low.
And she beat Mandyke, and Maddie had to commit the foul that time. So four unanswered for the Warriors. They have their first lead. It's 4-2 with 4:36 to play here in the opening quarter. St. Juice to the line, senior captain, averaging 12 points and 6 rebounds per contest. And according to her coach, Mike D'Angelo, she is a big-time mismatch for other teams.
Yeah, again, I've not seen the Hall girls play. They have really nice size for a women's team. And, you know, I saw Coach Huggins as she came just before she came back on, I think exhorting her to be more physical and aggressive offensively underneath.
1 of 2 at the line, and it's 4-3. Hall by a point as we come up on the midway point of the opening quarter. This is Reisner, long pass into the front court to O'Keefe. Kicked left side, Gellerman's three is no good, and St. Juice gets the rebound. Here's Delaney Connors into the front court. Ladd with the shot, missed it, and it's rebounded by Hall. Warriors looking to run at almost every opportunity. And the ball is knocked out of bounds.
I think that's, you know, when they run, I think they really allow Lena to find people. And if the other team covers defensively, then Delaney can find spots to, you know, catch the ball and shoot it. Looks like Hall's pretty comfortable pushing the ball, too. But, you know, they've taken about, I don't know, 5 threes already or long jumpers. So it's a contrast offensively in what their styles are.
Stolen by Conard. Here's Delaney Connors, pulls up with the jump. No good, it rims the basket, and the rebound to Reisner. One thing I've noticed, John, it's almost one and done every time down for Conard so far.
Yeah, you know, they're at the end of transition a lot of times. So, you know, the Hall's defenders are flooding the lane as, you know, they've missed, sadly, some layups and some closing shots. So they got numbers in there. So, yeah, they are one and done. They just got to make a couple more layups. They've missed like 4 or 5 thus far.
Oh, I know it. So here's Caroline at the free throw line, senior forward and a captain. Called by Brittany Huggins is just a huge defensive presence, looking for a little bit more offensively. And she misses the first foul shot. Substitutions for Hall. Jenna Zadanowicz and Olivia Boney back into the game. Marie Cotter and Maddie Mandyke check out for the Warriors. So Hall a little more free with the substitutions thus far in the opening 4.5 minutes. 1 of 2 for Caroline at the line, and Hall's lead is 2. 5-3 with 3.5 to play here in the opening quarter. Wide open underneath, the shot is missed, but a foul. Great position down low, and Maggie Venora will go to the free throw line.
Yeah, they lost Hall. Hall this time lost someone underneath and just allowed Venora to catch it and then had to foul her to miss the basket.
Maggie, her first year of varsity experience. And strong physical player for Mike D'Angelo. And misses the first. Both ends for free throws, like a lid on that basket, John.
Yeah, you know, again, you know, the whole Conard thing, we haven't really mentioned that, but, you know, there's a lot of expectations the players put on top of themselves, and, you know, the missed layups, and, you know, your touch is a little off until your body warms up and you just kind of forget about, you know, what you want to happen and just focus on playing what's in, you know, the situation in front of you. So, you know, I think, you know, this first quarter would be like that, you know, the boxing, big heavyweight match, and just kind of feeling each other out.
Sure, sure.
And then they'll settle early, into
early
the comfort
jitters.
Zone. Yeah, right, yeah, exactly.
5-4 Hall. Almost 5 minutes gone by here in the opening quarter. Lexi Gellerman. Guarded by Ladd, and Ladd strips the ball away. Here's Connors speeding into the front court. Delaney Connors all the way, lays it up and in. She's made a career of playing against Hall. Eddie Lytle's told us she averages almost 15 points a game in the matchups against Hall.
Yes, she has. She's a scorer. She likes to find the basket. She likes to get to the basket, and she likes to stick that jumper. She's got a nice stroke. She's a really nice player.
So at the other end, Olivia Boney on the drive. One of two freshmen who get a lot of minutes for this Hall team. She's an undersized big, but a big, tough, strong kid, according to Brittany Huggins. And she hits the first at the line.
Yeah, nice stroke to on a free throw. You can't coach big, you know, and she's got some big shoulders. She's a nice sized player. As a freshman, man, you're looking for players like her. She doesn't look like she's not kind of, she looks aggressive. She looks ready to go.
One of two at the line, and the game is tied at six as Jillian Haverty and Abigail Capone have checked in for Conard. Running one-hander by Tatiana is good. And Conard back in front, 8-6. Pretty move that time.
Yeah, there was a tough catch, too. They pretty got her the ball kind of on a short hop, and she did a great job of avoiding a defender and then getting to the basket. Connor's going after they score, trying to go a little 2-2-1 pressure back to a man-to-man defense. I don't know whether they're trying to, you know, control. It looks like they're just controlling tempo as opposed to trapping. They really haven't gone after Hall, but we'll see if they change that and become a little bit more aggressive with it later.
Talk about a seesaw battle. We've had four lead changes already. And the game is just 8-6. Last foul is on Haverty. And the free throw is good by Amber Reisner. Talk about a couple of big games that she's had this year, John. 33 against Southington, 19 against Plainville.
Wow.
She can light it up.
Yep, she can play.
Two of two at the line, and Amber Reisner has tied the game at 8, 2:15 to play here in the opening quarter as Lena Poretti directing traffic for the Chieftains. This is Haverty. Connors with the pass, and now a foul is going to be called, an offensive foul against Connors. It was away from the basketball. And
yeah,
the foul's on Tatiana.
I didn't see that play. They were running kind of a weave out front with the guards, and Tatiana, I think, was on the high post kind of setting a screen there. I was looking away from the ball for a second. I didn't see it.
So the Warriors with a chance to take their third lead of the night with the game tied at 8. This is Reisner, right side to Gellerman. This ball high overhead, tries to hit a cutting player underneath. That's Zdanowicz, and the ball knocked out of bounds. Zdanowicz, John, another one of those freshmen that we were talking about. So she had 9 points in the victory last night, contributing early on in her first year.
That's so great that a freshman can get varsity minutes. It's so beneficial to their development, confidence. That's definitely going to pay off for their program down the road.
I was going to ask you about that. How often did you try to incorporate underclassmen? You know, and Brittany and I talked about this. She said, hey, job one is winning, but we also know that, you know, we're going to be graduating some kids in a couple of years, and it's important to keep that continuity.
Well, yeah. I mean, for freshmen playing up at the higher levels, it's, you know, can they physically handle it? Can they emotionally handle it? Do they have the skill set? And sometimes a lot of kids are physically able and emotionally they're just not quite, you know, mature enough to handle that level of competition. But, I mean, you just have to play each case as it comes. And, you know, do the best you can. You know, if you have a kid that has a lot of potential, however, you want to kind of throw him into the fire a little bit just to kind of challenge him and test him a little bit. But a lot of times playing freshman that is just going to score 40 against every game doesn't benefit their growth.
Right. Three ball from the corner is good. Downtown Delaney Conard.
Back in here, 2-2-1.
And Conard in front, 11-8. A minute to play here in the opening quarter. Gellerman with the bounce pass for Mandyke. Back to Gellerman off the give and go. And a 3-second violation against Hall will give the basketball back to Conard.
Yeah, well, Hall, too, looks like when the last couple sets that they've run, they've kind of been a little stagnant. They haven't been that efficient with their half-court sets. Both teams have been pretty successful pushing the ball, so we'll see if, you know, running the half-court is a benefit to Hall or they really need to get out and run a little bit.
Here's Prior-Eddie with the basketball. 35 seconds to go. Conard's with the step. Up and in. That's five in a row for Delaney, and the lead is five.
Nice aggressive move.
And a foul is going to be called on Conard, and Mike D'Angelo can't believe it.
Yeah, Haverty, I thought. I mean, I thought she did a great job playing defense all the way across. I mean, officials, I think, really need to look for whether the defense is trying to gain an advantage. And that time they were going, you know, east to west. There was no pushing or shoving. That's something I think they could, you know, in terms of letting them play.
Yeah.
If she's going to the basket, that's a whole other story.
Left wing shot is good. That's Zdanowicz, the freshman, and it's 13-10. 8 seconds to go. Prior-Eddie loses control. Ball is loose. Conard comes away with it with 3 seconds. Here's Conard's with the shot. No good. And the opening quarter comes to an end. Good spirited opening 8 minutes. And Conard has the lead, John Benyon, 13-10 after one.
Yeah, a really good first half. A little slow to start. You know, Conard was unfortunate to miss, you know, a bunch of layups early. Would have been a little bit different, but both teams are a little off initially, and it looks like they're starting to settle in a little bit more to half court. It'll be interesting for me to see. I haven't seen Hall play, and I don't know what their style is. And Conard, obviously, to me, it looks like they like to run and use their guard play to kind of put the other team back on their heels. But Hall looks like they like to run half court sets. I'm not sure what their strength is yet.
Well, the War Chief Sports Council would like to thank our many fine sponsors, including those at the captain's level. And they would be Hartford Distributors, Franklin Fine Beers, Cork and Bottle, the Babe Ruth Organization, Coastal Tool and Rob Ludkin, and the Conard and Hall PTO. And also our lone all-conference supporter, and that would be Allied Printing. Thanks to one and all for your continued support of the War Chief Sports Council to make broadcasts like tonight and tomorrow afternoon possible. Got a great winter sports schedule coming your way. Got the basketball tonight and tomorrow. Got girls hockey a week from Monday on the 30th and then into February. We have a Conard boys hockey game and we have wrestling and boys swimming as well. So 6 games in the next 4 weeks coming your way on WHC-TV Channel 5 in conjunction with the War Chief Sports Council. Opening possession of the second quarter. 13-10 the score. St. Just with the shot, and it's up and good. So Tatiana now has 5. She and Conard's have combined for 12 of the 15 thus far for the Chieftains.
They are definitely, the Chieftains are definitely looking to throw the ball deep to their whoever their big person in there is. And it looks like they're maybe trying to take advantage of Hall's height and not being able to get down the floor. I don't know whether Hall has an issue with that, but the Chieftains are definitely looking to get it down quickly and then look in right away, either with a pass or a drive.
Maddie Mandyke with the last basket for the Hall Warriors. Prior-Eddie on the drive, misses the shot, in good position on the rebound for Hall as Conard came away with it. Reisner all the way misses the shot, and they tie it up underneath. Talking about Maddie Mandyke in the last basket, interesting story about her, John, coming all the way back from a torn ACL last year. That's a long recovery. and she looks like she's at full speed.
Yeah, I give athletes so much credit for putting in the tremendous amount of work coming back from an injury like that. It's really great to see.
15-12. As Ladd tried to back her way in, and Zdanowicz is going to get called for the foul. Non-shooting foul, so Conard will put it in from underneath their own basket. St. Juice out, Maggie Venora back in the lineup for Mike D'Angelo's team. Mike, in his first year as the head coach, came over after 11 years as an assistant at Trinity College.
That college game had to be just a wealth of, you know, experience for him. At that level, you know, all those great players. I've had a chance just to talk to Coach briefly. Seems like a great guy. The girls are, you know, enjoying his coaching. I guess he's been really demanding of them, and so far the vibe there, I think, is pretty good.
Yeah, absolutely. Hey, when you take a 17-3 team that graduated six kids, and you come back and rebound with 11-1 in his first head coaching job. Asked him why he made the switch from college to high school. He said, very simple. I have two young kids, and I don't want to miss any more of their birthdays.
Yeah. You know, I missed, I've been talking since I'm, you know, on the tail end of my teaching and coaching career. I've talked to people about, you know, visiting with my nine-month-old granddaughter. She's 9 months old today, and my kid's out in Denver. Yeah. And sometimes I say the best and worst thing I've ever done is coach, because I, you know, my kid missed my kids a lot growing up.
Sure.
But yeah, he's a wise man. That college schedule is very, very demanding. I'm sure it took him away from home a lot.
It did. He said between the games and the recruiting, he said the travel was a little too much. And he said it had to be the perfect storm, though. And he said, in talking with everybody around the Conard program, he said it was. It was a perfect fit. And
yep.
So far, so good.
Yep.
Conard basketball in the front court. St. Juice tries to go baseline. Her shot is blocked, knocked out of bounds. Great baseline defense, Caroline O'Keefe that time.
Yeah, great defense, Tatiana. Maybe one more dribble and then a spin or up strong. She just, that was her patented move. It was easy to read that time for the D, so maybe a little something different next time down.
Gellerman walking it across, picked up by Connors. Ball is stripped, but controlled by Reisner. 3 minutes gone by, second quarter. It's been a tight one throughout. Biggest lead has been 5 to this point. As we're going to have a foul called away from the play. It's a pushing foul.
Yeah, Ladd tried to run through the screen that time. I think she was a little annoyed by the screen being there. Instead of fighting over the top or running behind, she kind of tried to run through Caroline.
So here's Caroline. As that foul put Conard over the limit. First of the 1-1 by Caroline is good. As we talked about before, at the free throw line, she's more known for her defensive tactics. She'll always guard the best big player on the other team. And that's St. Juice tonight.
Well, you know, I've been watching the big kids for Hall come down, retreat on defense, and, you know, on offense, through their feet. Their agility, their coordination is pretty good for big kids. Coaches love to watch kids that are agile, that are that size, and, you know, they move very well.
A little momentum on the side of the Warriors here as they've cut the 5-point deficit down to 1. It's 15-14. Foul called against Liz Ladd, her second. That's the team's 8th, and she'll be replaced in the lineup by Jillian Haverty. And that'll send Caroline O'Keefe back to the free throw line.
Yeah, maybe a little bit of frustration on Liz's part there. It's good for Coach to have her sit down and kind of sort things out a little bit before she gets back in.
Misses the first of the 1-1, and Venora grabs the rebound for Conard. Delaney Connors. Pretty move, and in with the shot is Venora.
Yeah.
Great move down the lane that time.
Yeah, nice little up fake, raised the defender, and then took her right to the basket. Great shot.
That ends a 4-0 run for Hall, and it puts Conard back in front by 3. 17-14 with 4.5 to play here in the opening half. A reverse move is just missed that time by Reisner. Circus shot, and the ball inadvertently was knocked out of bounds by Conard. It'll stay Hall possession.
Yeah, tough break for Conard, but great move on the other to start that whole play. Reisner can, you know, showed her ability to handle the ball and her speed to get to the basket. She just blew right by the Conard defenders.
Siobhan Boyle in for Alexi Dellerman. Boyle, the sophomore. And the youngest child of Coach Steve Boyle, who, like you, does an excellent job on our broadcast.
Steve's a good guy. He doesn't have any more kids, does he?
I don't think
so. Is this
the
last one?
I think it's the last one.
He's got to stop having these kids beat up on Conard.
Yeah, Siobhan is a sophomore. Steve, of course, was an assistant coach for Jeff Kaplowitz for years for the Hall Warriors.
That was on Caroline O'Keefe. There was a push. I didn't really see it. Again, looking away from the ball, or I was watching the ball that time.
So the foul on Caroline, her first. Conard up three. Exactly half of the second quarter remaining. 4 minutes to play until halftime. A reminder coming up at halftime. Hall student Tom Zinzarello will join us as the three ball is hit from the corner by Tatiana. 20-14. We're saying Tom Zinzarello will join us. He'll have a recap so far of the winter sports seasons. Great driving move by Reisner. Can't get it to go. And the rebound to Conard. And in the front court is Jillian Haverty. Passes it off to St. Juice. Hits the trailer, Perrette. He thought about the three. She drives instead. Up with the left hand. No good. But she's fouled. Good sequence offensively.
Yeah, Tatiana made a good decision not to shoot the ball. Perrette called for the ball. Nice little up fake again. And then took it to the rim. Got hit as she was trying to lay it in. They do a nice job, the Chieftains, of pushing that ball up the floor.
Yeah, they really do. Coach D'Angelo calls Lena an extension of him on the floor. You like having those guards that run the show that can be a second coach, don't you, Coach?
Yeah, she's always, even in eighth grade phys ed classes, I noticed that she has this calm affect, you know, and competitiveness that you love to see in kids that run the show for you. And she's obviously done a great job for the Chieftains.
And she hits two of two at the line. And it's the biggest lead of the night at eight. And Hall calls for timeout. Comes with 3:31 to play here in the opening half. 22-14. The Chieftains in charge as it is a 30-second timeout. The War Chief Sports Council would like to thank our many fine sponsors, including those at the varsity level. Low Tide Photography, Blue Plate, Dave Newman Photography, Fast Eddie, West Hartford Youth Basketball, West Hartford Travel Boys Basketball, Open Arm Christian Ministries, Final Cut Barbershop, Edward Connors Insurance, Stanley and Elaine Phillips, Beth Barry Brown of the William Ravis Agency, and West Hartford Girls Lacrosse. Thanks to one and all for your sponsorship of the War Chief Sports Council. For more info on how you can join the sponsorship, go to the website www.war-chief.net. That's war-chief.net. 22-14. Biggest lead of the night at eight for the Chieftains. Hall basketball off the timeout. Reisner into the front court. Guarded by Poirietti. Here's Gellerman looking to drive. O'Keefe baseline gets the shot to go and a foul. She has some pretty post moves down, doesn't she?
Yeah, she does. Yeah, she does. Been an aggressive move to the basket. The Conard defenders took bad angles to shut the baseline down on her, kind of let her, you know, kind of almost jog into the basket. But she made a nice strong move. Again, big kid like her, good feet, attack the basket hard. That's a nice thing to see.
Haverty picks up her third foul, replaced by Ladd, who has two fouls. So a little foul difficulty for the Chieftains. Missing the three-point play opportunity was O'Keefe, but she leads all Hall scorers with seven. St. Juste has eight. As we have a backcourt violation.
A little bit of a miscue on a cut. But the Chieftains showed a little bit of a full court press last time. I'm wondering whether they're going to try to change the, you know, try to get up into Hall a little bit. They denied the inbounds pass and make them work for it a little bit, bringing it in.
This is Kellerman with the basketball. Hits a cutting Maddie Mandyke misses the shot. Second opportunity, no good. Rebound again for Hall. O'Keefe thought about the long-range shot, thought better of it. Perimeter passing now by the Warriors. Long-range three is an air ball. It's missed by Reisner. Back tap, loose on the floor, and controlled by the Chieftains. This is Prietti speeding into the front court. Pretty move by Ladd, and it's blocked by O'Keefe. Great defense, and then a double team and a foul. Connors and Prietti converging that time on Gellerman in the backcourt, and the foul was called. Boy, we saw one pretty move by Ladd, and even better defense by O'Keefe to reject it.
Yeah, O'Keefe gobbled that one up pretty well. That the other end, the last possession, pretty reminiscent of last year when they played at Conard. When Connor got up and tried to defend him hard man-to-man, started back cut. They had like a little five-person open set. Hall ran just recently, and it's a passing cut, very simple, pretty popular set. And they've already had like three or four open looks at that. So the Chieftains will have to be smart about how and where they pressure Hall in that kind of situation.
Gellerman, one of two at the line. And the Conard lead is 5. 22-17 Chieftains with 2:10 to play in the opening half. Here's St. Just in the lane. Misses the shot. The Hall crowd thought that Maddie Mandyke got all basketball that time. But not the case.
I think Maddie got a lot of ball there that time. But, stuff's happening pretty fast out there. One of the toughest games to officiate there is, I think.
No doubt. So here's Tatiana back at the line, leading all scorers with 8 points so far tonight. And she hits the first. Chieftains lead by a half dozen. They've led by as many as 8 in this opening half. And the second is good. 24-17.
A little man-to-man full court pressure. They've been just retreating out of this pressure back and playing man-to-man. They really haven't gone all out at them.
Conard led 13-10 at the quarter. They've outscored Hall 11-7 here in the second. O'Keefe tried to take it all the way. Missed the shot. Rebound is put back up and in. Conard controlled it. They lost it. And Siobhan Boyle the pocket of the Conard Chieftain, got the shot, drew the contact, and tried to finish an old-fashioned three-point play.
Yeah, we were a little confused there on D, and then a half-hearted defensive effort. If you're going to foul someone sometimes, you're better off not, you're taking a good chunk of that ball
sure. As
they go up, so, they're not looking at three.
And Boyle hits the shot. And the lead is cut to 4, 24-20, with a 1:40 to play here in the first half. Tatiana thought about the three, instead kicks it back out to Ladd. Tatiana's three ball from the corner. It is short, and the rebound is loose underneath. Four players scrum for it, and it's going to be a jump ball. And the possession arrow will give it back to Hall.
That kind of showed the five-out set that time, too, looking for passing and cutting. Or a kick for a three. Tatiana took it that time.
So here are the Warriors with an opportunity to draw closer as Reisner walks it across. This is Gellerman. Wide open right wing shot is too long, and Connors has the rebound on the other side. Tries to get it ahead. Bass is deflected. Almost stolen, but Connors controls it. And Conard, in the person of Mike D'Angelo, the head coach, asks for and gets a timeout with 1:01 to go here until halftime. A little helter-skelter in the Conard backcourt. But again, one thing, John, throughout this first half that we've seen, a lot of one-and-dones for Conard, and Hall still in this basketball game because they've done a great job off the offensive glass creating those extra opportunities.
Right. Conard could, well, both teams, but Conard's, I think, has had a couple more scoring opportunities that could have knocked in. And, you know, with those five-out sets that are pretty popular now, you know, there's, if you think about it, a passer and a cutter and four people on the perimeter, you know, how many people do you send? A lot of coaches like to keep two people back to defend against the fast break, but right now, the only person that's attacking the basket is the one that's cutting to the basket, and they're left alone against three or four defenders.
Do you think that's more because Conard trusts their outside shooting, or because they figure because Hall has such a presence of bigs underneath?
No, you like to spread, you know, this nowadays teams like to spread you out and use, you know, their dribble and or shooting ability. You get a little penetration, you kick it out to Conard or what have you. And then like this just play that just happened, if they play a little bit too tight, no one's in there, you can back cut. You know, there's a pass there. So there's a number of advantages. Rebounding is probably one of the bigger disadvantages, running that kind of set. That's the way a lot of people play basketball nowadays. A lot of cutting room, a lot of dribbling room.
Coach D'Angelo not happy. And back to the free throw line is Lexi Gellerman. And she misses the first. Abigail Capone back in the lineup. Tatiana gets a rest. She's got two fouls. Don't want to have her pick up number three before halftime.
No, that's a good move. Give Capone a little bit of time. Get her feet wet. Have Tatiana rest a little bit. Protect against foul trouble. Good move.
Four unanswered points for Hall, 24-21. Conard's on the cut, missed the shot, but she drew contact and will go to the free throw line.
Yep, there's that simple pass and cut again with an open set, and if the defender doesn't jump to the ball side to defend that pass coming in, those kids are open quite a bit.
Sure. So Delaney Conard's averaging 16 points and 4 rebounds per contest this year. Hits the first at the line. She's exactly halfway to her average. She has 8. And that first foul shot ended that mini 4-0 run for Hall. Gets the shooter's roll that time. 2 of 2 at the line. She has 9, 26-21. The Conard lead at 5 with 20 seconds to go here in the opening half. And we'll see if Hall holds for the final shot. It appears that they will. This is Gellerman. 7 seconds to go. Finds the cutter. Shot on the way. No good. Steps are going to be called. One too many steps for Boyle that time as she tried to go left-handed to the basket.
Yeah, nice patience. They found someone. Boyle, again, the ball just got away from her a little bit. She had an extra step in there.
Conard's with a final shot at the buzzer, rejected by Caroline O'Keefe. And I believe that's the way the first half should come to a conclusion. There's no time left on the clock. Both coaches want to know what's going on. And that is, in fact, the end of the first half. So with the score, Conard 26 and Hall 21. And John Benyeh, your overall impressions of that opening half?
Good half. I mean, I think both coaches would probably say that they're a little bit disappointing with their ability to finish. You know, Hall early. First quarter, you know, they put up some jumpers, which I'm sure they have made throughout the season, a number of them. The Chieftains, on the other hand, you know, early on, a lot of attacks, close shots, layups missed. Defensively, you know, both teams, pretty good job. Hall Biggs played well. The Conard guards did a great job pushing the ball and distributing it. So, you know, it's been kind of a mixed bag of things that happened, in the first half. But, you know, good game so far. I mean, you know, a couple people make some threes, and you know how quickly that kind of scoring can turn a game around.
Sure.
You know, and Hall looks very confident in shooting that ball, so it makes me think that, you know, it could be a strength of theirs. So we'll see what happens. Maybe going to find the range, the second half.
If Reisner or Gellerman get hot, that could change the fortune.
Reisner's been at the basket with her dribble and some shots, and just two or three of them just rolling out off the rim. So, she's going to definitely get hers. The second half is probably going to make a big difference.
Looking forward to it. Should be a good second half. 26-21. Again, Conard in front, the War Chief Sports Council. We'd like to thank our many fine sponsors, including those at the all-state level, Keating Insurance Agency, Macca Plumbing and Heating, Reed and Reach PC, Counselors at Law, ESPN, the Entertainment and Sports Programming Network, and College Prep Express. Thanks to one and all for your continued patronage of the War Chief Sports Council to make broadcasts like tonight possible. Again, we have about 7.5 minutes until the start of the third quarter, and we're pleased to be joined by Hall Senior, Tom Zinzarella, who's a passionate sports fan, has a few college choices that he's going to be making, but as he follows the sports scene here in West Hartford, and he's going to give us a recap of what's going on in the winter.
Thank you, Pete. So as the Hall Lady Warriors try to extend their 5-game winning streak, Conard standing tall as they hold a slim 26-21 lead. The Hall Sunnington boys hockey have started on a slow 2-4-1 start and are looking to turn the corner. Hall senior captain Jacob Hurd leads the team in goals and assists while the team is building more and more chemistry every day. Junior defenseman Andrew Mitchell is an enforcer on the boards while Hall awaits Kobe Glynn, who's looking to come back from an injury very soon. With his return and the growth of the team, the sky is the limit for this team. Conner Hall girls hockey team are off to a hot start with a respectable 9-3 record. At this point last year, the girls compiled a 5-3-1 record. The girls will try to continue their 4-game winning streak as they host Notre Dame Fairfield tomorrow at Veterans. Puck drop at 1 p.m. The Warriors wrestling team has seen contributions from all over. Senior Brad Kerr leading the charge, having finished first in the Greater Hartford Open in his weight class. Junior Hugh Wells is getting better every week and looking to take over for Courier next season, as he also finished first in his weight class at the Greater Hartford Open. The Warriors will try to avenge their defeat this week as they head to the new Milford tournament that starts tomorrow. The Warriors boys swimming senior leadership has been paying off, as Captain Andrew Swain already has one state qualifier under his belt in the 100-meter breaststroke. Sophomore Ian Harker has been putting up impressive numbers yet again. He's already qualified for the 100-meter backstroke and the 100-meter butterfly. The Warriors take their 3-1 record with them as they head on the road to take on Avon later tonight. Don't forget to tune on in tomorrow as Aiden Malone and the Conard Chieftains go on to face Dan Brock and the Hall Warriors. Right here tomorrow, Robinson Gym. Scheduled tip is 3 p.m. This is your halftime report. I'm Thomas Zinzarella.
Tom, thank you. Great job as always. Look forward to seeing you tomorrow for the basketball game. And what are your impressions of the opening half so far?
Well, it's a typical Hall-Conard game. You know, it's going back and forth. It's not going to be the clean game. It's a lot of turnovers. It could be cleaned up a bit, but I think the team that whoever, you know, takes the most opportunities off of the free throw line will eventually win this game.
Yeah, I think so too, and it's incumbent upon both of those teams to improve that free throw shooting, which was less than stellar for sure here in the opening half. So thanks to Tom, as always, not only for his report, but for helping the broadcast as well. And we'll hear much more from him as the rest of this senior campaign for him and the rest of our winter sports season and spring sports season go forward. Jen and the fine folks at WHC-TV want me to remind you and tell you that if you're watching the broadcast locally, go to channel 96. We're switching from channel 5 to 96. More audio and video capabilities over on channel 96 tonight than channel 5. 4 minutes away from the start of the third quarter, and we'll come back with second half action right after this. You're watching West Hartford High School Sports on WHC-TV, channel 5 and 96, as presented by the War Chief Sports Council. Well, 96 crew. Thanks to Jen and to Meredith and Diana for keeping us on the air and on time. 26-21. Chieftain scored 13 points in each of the first two quarters. Outscored Hall 13-10 in the first, 13-11 in the second. Weak side rebound for the Warriors. And it's knocked out of bounds, last touched by Hall. So, Coach Beignet, what do you look for here in the second half for Hall to get back into this ball game?
Not quite sure which way they want to go. You know, I kind of right away they came right back at attacking the basket, and I'm not sure. We'll see. I think they're, again, equally comfortable shooting the ball. They do a good job running half-court sets. They certainly had a lot of looks that have come up empty. You know, and if they can, both teams can put the ball, I think it's just a matter of who can put the ball in more frequently now. Obviously. You know, based on what they want to do. So, I don't know. It'll be interesting to see who can do what better.
Pretty pass that time from Mandyke to Conard, and Marie was wide open underneath for the first basket of the second half. And now a steal by the Warriors. And it's a one-possession basketball game with 6:45 to play here in the third. 26-23. A couple of empty trips for Conard to start play here in the third quarter. Reisner, long three off the front of the iron, no good, and St. Just has the rebound. Hands it off to Connors. Here's Delaney speeding all the way, and the shot is rejected and knocked out of bounds. Boy, I sound like a broken record, John, but Caroline O'Keefe has been just a magnificent defensive presence tonight.
Connors has been under the basket so much tonight and come away empty a lot of times, and Caroline's obviously one of the big reasons. She looks very comfortable defending in there.
And another turnover as Conard traveled with the basketball. And Hall will get it back. As we said, first of two meetings between these squads. They meet again at Conard on Monday, February 13th. That'll be a 7 o'clock start. Three ball was short. Ball is loose on the court. And Ladd comes away with it for the Chieftains. Hands it off to Connors. Bounce pass ahead to St. Just in the front court. This is Proietti. Skip pass for Ladd. Tries to back her way around Keith and loses the ball out of bounds.
Yeah, Liz lost the handle there. Had a good idea. Attacked the middle of the basket. Tried to spin, but her feet got a little tangled up and just kind of lost the ball there out of bounds. Well, and Reisner comes down and does the same thing.
Yeah.
She is a good penetrator, I'll tell you. And that first shot she took was a little softer, although it was a miss. It was a little softer touching the rim. So she might be, zoning in a little bit on that jump shot of hers.
And as you talked about, too, with that penetration, she has great acceleration with that first step. She can just blow by the defenders.
Absolutely. Good handle.
Three ball from the top of the circle is no good, and O'Keefe has the rebound. Lenora missing that last shot for Conard. This is Gellerman in the front court, guarded by Proietti.
Running five out, a little passing, a little screen opposite.
Mandyke thought about that three initially. Gellerman able to save it from going out of bounds. And O'Keefe called for steps.
But defensively, when Paul goes five people out, stay close to shooters and not get screened off for a lot of penetration, kind of stymies that defense. So you can't pass the ball, or there isn't any dribble penetration either. So kind of did a good job defensively that time.
Tatiana tries to go baseline, and again, O'Keefe knocking it away and out of bounds. Brittany Huggins off the bench. Not happy with some development from her team right there. As Proietti gets set to inbounds and gets it into Tatiana. Long three on the way. It's short. And the weak side rebound by Mandyke, and she was fouled. That is. Yeah. So three on Ladd, three on Jillian Haverty, who's substituted for Ladd. 26-23. Running one-hander is a wild shot off the backboard and is controlled by Conard. Coming up on the halfway point of the third quarter, the Chieftains still looking for their first points of the second half. They had 26 at halftime, and the ball is stolen by Mandyke. Hands it off to Gellerman. Again, we were 26-21 at the break. Hall is outscored Conard 2-0 in the first 4 minutes of this third quarter. O'Keefe loses control of the basketball, but they're going to say last touch by Conard. And the Warriors will hang with it.
Yeah, Coach Huggins just yelled out for her kids to relax, relax, relax. Both teams are playing pretty solid defense right now, but the offense is suffering a bit. Maybe again, you know, they're trying to, you know, one team's trying to push ahead and the other team's trying to, you know, maybe a little thinking too much about, you know, what's going on instead of just executing what they're supposed to be running.
There's Amber Reisner. Tries to go by Connors. Hands it off for Mandyke. Ball is loose. Controlled underneath. Baseline shot. He's around the rim and in. Marie Conard able to get the shooter's roll that time. Back the other way is Ladd. And the ball is knocked out of bounds.
Yeah, Bliss tried to draw a foul that time. Didn't work. But the Hall defenders did touch the ball, so Connors got it back.
So Mandyke out. Olivia Boney checks back into the basketball game for the Warriors. Lena Proietti, leader in assists and steals for this Conard team. The inbounds pass goes all the way into the backcourt where it's chased down by Jillian Haverty. Gets it ahead to Conard, now back to Haverty. Conard's thought about the shot, drives, takes it up, no good with the shot, but she's fouled. Pretty move that time by the junior, Delaney Conard. And she'll get herself to the free throw line, John.
Yep. It's almost, you know, it's hard. It almost seems like sometimes the kids, they get a little bit too deep with their penetration. That brings Caroline, the Hall defender, into play, and she's been knocking balls away. If they could get, like, midway to the basket, maybe pull up and shoot that little 6-to-8-footer, get a little separation from their defender, maybe they could have more success. I don't know. I mean, they're certainly doing a great job getting to the rim. You just got to find a way to maybe just get it a little higher on the glass, a little softer over Caroline's hands. A little adjustment like that might do a world of good for them.
Sure. 2 of 2 at the line for Delaney Conard. She now has 11. And the Chieftains took 4 minutes and 45 seconds to get their initial points here in the third quarter. But they built their lead back up to 3, 28-25, and now a steal. Here's Maggie Venora. Nice bounce pass to Delaney Conard. Off the glass and in, and a foul. Pretty 2-on-1, worked to perfection that time. Venora, a pretty pass to Delaney Conard, and she'll go to the line looking for the old-fashioned 3-point play.
Yep, started Venora. Second time I've seen her tip a ball away like that, once in the first half, then a second. And, you know, I'm not going to say it's Conard basketball, it looks like, but they look very comfortable, you know, converting points from their defense. So, nice job by Venora.
Foul on O'Keefe, her second, team second. And the free throw is good. So in a matter of 13 seconds, Delaney Conard scores 5 points.
Yep.
31-25, lead back up to 6. Chieftains have led by as many as 8 in the contest here tonight. 2:50, time remaining here in the third quarter. John, a lot of time, obviously, to go in this basketball game, 10 minutes and 50 seconds. Big possession here, though, for Hall, trying to stem the tide a little bit. They're down 6, don't want to let it get even further away.
Right, right. And they're fishing a little bit for a back cut there on that set. You know, trying to take advantage of Conard's over-aggressiveness on defense. But they got to find something that sometimes, you know, it doesn't make a difference what teams run. As long as they're comfortable doing it,
yeah,
you know what I mean. Just to, sure, to get them to get back in that comfort zone offensively that you need. So sometimes we used to ask the kids, like, "Look, what do you want to run?"
Yeah,
you know, and they'll say, "Let's run this," and it could be the wrong matchup or what have you. But at least they go out and they get a little bit of confidence doing something successful.
Sure,
I think that's just what Hall needs as well.
Connors again. Good! She has 8 points in a row. And it's 34-25 with 2:20 to play in the third.
Little full court man. Delaney Connors is, she's been up on raising her pretty hard. She's been a ball distributor for a good part of the start of the second half instead of a scorer. Looks like they're maybe trying to take her out of the offense a little bit.
Biggest lead of the night for the Chieftains, as the Warriors need a basket.
An illegal screen on Maria Cotter. Just leaned a little bit into the Conard defender, and we're going the other way with the ball.
And a timeout taken with 1:54 to play here in the third quarter. It's Conard 34, Hall 25 here on WHC-TV. Channel 96 tonight. Hopefully we'll be back on Channel 5 tomorrow for our boys basketball game at 3 o'clock. Join John and me for that one. The War Chief Sports Council would like to thank our many fine sponsors, including those at the captain's level: Hartford Distributors, Franklin Fine Beers, Cork and Bottle, the Babe Ruth Organization, Coastal Tool and Rob Ludkin, and the Conard and Hall PTO. At the all-conference level, Allied Printing, and at the varsity level, Low Tide Photography, Blue Plate, Dave Newman Photography, Fast Eddie, West Hartford Youth Basketball, West Hartford Travel Boys Basketball, the Open Arm Christian Ministries, Final Cut Barbershop, Edward Connors Insurance, Stanley and Elaine Phillips, Beth Barry Brown of the William Ravis Agency, and West Hartford Girls Lacrosse. Thanks to one and all for your sponsorship of the War Chief Sports Council. 1:54 to play here in the third, off the timeout. Conard basketball trying to get that lead into double digits for the first time tonight. They're up 34-25. They're on an 8-0 run over the last 90 seconds. Connors spins her way into the lane, and it goes out of bounds. Last touched by the Warriors.
Yeah, there's another example, I think, of just trying to get a little bit too deep. She made a great initial move. She spun, which is excellent. And then she tried to split into two defenders, and just kind of ball kind of got jammed up into their arms. Just creating and understanding how to create a little bit of space so you can get her shot off would be great. I mean, she can stroke it.
Jillian Haverty. She didn't call that one. She banked it off glass.
That was a nice deposit in the bank late in the evening.
And the three ball makes it 37-25. 10-0 run. And a foul against Hall. Push off. And it's amazing how this game has just completely changed, John, in the last minute and 50 seconds.
Yeah, it has. Connors certainly sparked the Chieftains early, and Hall's been struggling a little bit offensively, a couple turnovers here and there. Again, they just need to find something. You know, maybe raising her, penetrate, or a jumper by her, or a post player. they need a bucket the next possession, stem the tide a little bit.
Bounce pass to Tatiana. She kicks it back outside. This is Proietti. She and Connors play catch on the perimeter. Back outside. Delaney, long three is good. Delaney Connors again. 40-25. She has half of her team's points. She now has 20.
Yeah, great decisions by the other Chieftains not to force the ball. I mean, they were up. They had plenty of time. Moved the ball a little bit. Someone forgot where Delaney was, which is not a good idea, obviously. And she drained it.
Off the turnover. Proietti back the other way. 24 seconds to go. And we'll see if Conard holds for one. And actually, Mike D'Angelo has asked for and receives a 30-second timeout. 40-25, Conard. 19 and 2/10 seconds to play here in the third quarter. And you know, something I haven't seen, John, very interesting in terms of the way the schedule was made. This is the finale of six straight away from home for Conard, and they have a chance to win all six if they can hold on to the victory tonight.
Well, you know, in any sport, it's tough to win on the road. So, you know, that speaks volumes for a team. And, you know, if there's six away, you're going to get the other end of that coming, you know, the other part of the season, which is good.
Sure.
You know, you build some confidence winning on the road, and then, you know, you get some home cooking and some confidence, and, you know, that bodes well for them. So, you know, I do want to say something. I've noticed in the crowd here there's Judah Pippo and Norbert Deslauriers and Delaney's dad. I haven't seen him. I'm sure he's here. The point being is that those guys are all the youth league coaches and the travel league coaches.
Oh,
they
point.
Do a great job of coaching these girls. I saw a practice a week ago, and the stuff that was being taught and how it was being taught was high school quality, top-notch stuff, on point. It was really fun to watch.
Nice. Also want to recognize some of the Hall and Conard coaches in the stands. Brian Moretti, who we'll see tomorrow. And Tom Berengia and Greg, who led Conard to the state championship softball title back in 2011.
Yep. Coach Van Meyerhauser is in the house as well.
Yeah.
Saw those guys scouting at Conard last night, along with Coach Stillman from Simsbury. Great bunch of guys, very, very talented coaches.
And very dedicated and passionate.
Yeah,
too.
They sure are. Yeah. West Harper's lucky to have those guys.
40-25, long drought for Hall. They've gone 3 minutes and 20 seconds without a point. Stolen by Conard, 5 seconds to go in the front court, and retaken back by the Hall Warriors. Buzzer beater on the way is short, and that's the way the third quarter ends.
I'll tell you what, Jillian Haverty, I would, you know, I just want her to walk me to my car just in case someone jumps me or something. She is a tough kid. She scrapped for that ball, got it started the other way. She just, you know, she's the kind of, well, I'm going to speak for coaches, she's the kind of player in that kind of a defensive intensity, and just the work ethic is just, I just love watching her get after it.
Yeah, and she really does, no doubt about it. So what a conclusion to the third quarter for the Chieftains. This game was once 26-25 with 3:15 to go in the third quarter. Conard closes on a 14-0 run. And 11 of those from Delaney Connors, who has 20 to lead all scorers in the contest. 40-25 at the end of three, as you're watching West Hartford High School Sports here on WHC-TV, channels 5 and 96, as presented by the War Chief Sports Council. John, if you're Brittany Huggins, 8 minutes to go, you're down 15. Can she remind her kids that they had a 12-point lead at Conard last year, and Conard came back to win, and maybe they can try to duplicate
She's
that.
Telling her kids just to calm down, play. Reisner, like Connors, can do exactly the same thing for Hall that Delaney just did for Conard. Very quickly put points on the board. So, you know, they just have to not panic, just continue to do what they do. Nice little back cut right there. There it is.
And there's the first basket of the fourth quarter. Jenna Zadanowicz got free, and it's 40-27. That ends the 14-0 Conard run. Jenna also for Hall can score in spurts. She had 9 points last night. Five of those came in one quarter. And a foul called at the other end. Non-shooting foul.
Yep.
Team fouls. I'm sorry, John.
No, I'm sorry. I'm just thinking, you know, there's a lot of time. You ask a question about what coach is going to say to the Hall girls, and Coach Huggins is, you know, she's been in the situation as a player and as a coach a number of times, so I know she's not panicked. She's just trying to exhort her kids on, you know, playing Hall basketball.
Yeah. Talked about Coach Huggins, her first year as the varsity head coach, replacing Jeff Kaplowitz, who had such a long, successful run for the Warriors. Shot is missed. Rebound, O'Keefe, no good, and a foul should go to the line. But Brittany was the JV coach here last year and has a length of junior varsity experience at Windsor, where she was after she graduated from Pace University years ago.
Yeah, she brings a lot of experience and a fresh look, I guess, for the girls. Also, you know, in terms of girls coaches, many would argue that there needs to be more females coaching females, and I certainly do agree with that. It's just you know, a much more comfortable thing, I think, for the young girls in town to see a great role model like Coach Huggins.
That's a good point. Two for two for Caroline O'Keefe at the line. Four straight for Hall. Back to an 11-point game. A minute gone by here in the fourth quarter. Here's Proietti for St. Juste. Long-range jump is no good, and is rebounded underneath by Maddie Mandyke. Here's Reisner into the front court. Tries to go all the way, hits the shot, and it's 40-31. 6-0 run for Hall to begin the fourth quarter. Pass underneath, out of bounds. And a timeout taken by Mike D'Angelo, just like that. Hall's worked their way back in it.
Yeah, great look by Peretti. Just the pass was just a hair off. And there goes the pace. The pace just kicked up a little bit. Benefited the Hall Warriors. And good timeout by Coach to just kind of calm them down a little bit and regroup this team.
Yeah, their last two possessions, Tatiana took the long-range shot that she missed. And then underneath, ball was thrown away that time. You're being recognized by the faithful down here in the hall section.
Oh, yeah. And it looks like the sixth grade West Hartford girls travel basketball team, coached by Coach Deslauriers, former Conard boys basketball captain of mine.
Oh, okay. Nice. Nice connection there.
Yeah.
So again, just a reminder that John and I will join you for boys basketball action tomorrow afternoon at 3, right back here at Robinson Gymnasium. Brian Moretti's 6-3 Hall Warriors against Conard under the direction of Jared Leghorn, the 3-year head coach there. They're 3-7, but they come off a win last night. 3 o'clock, opening tip tomorrow on WHC-TV Channel 5. Here's O'Keefe with the shot. It's good! Caroline O'Keefe, it's an 8-0 run, 40-33, the lead is 7. And they've done this in under 2 minutes, John.
It's the game can turn on a dime.
Offensive rebound, no good, knocked out of bounds. Last touch by the Chieftains, it'll be Hall basketball.
A little momentum swing here, and now the Chieftains are on the other side of it. You know, they're going to have to, you know, execute. Run something that they feel comfortable with. Take good shots. Hall's going to continue to attack, I'm sure.
Three ball from the corner is good! Ball hitting the three. 40-36. Down to 4. Hall has outscored Conard 11-0 in the first 2:20 of this fourth quarter. Pass is thrown out of bounds. And who's the first one up to cheer on the Hall side? Brian Moretti. I think that's great to see when the boys' coach is cheering so hard for the
absolutely, team. Absolutely. Brian's a great guy. You know, both sets of coaches and players, guys, girls that support each other. That's why it's such a great rivalry.
Running one-hander is no good by Maddie Mandyke, but she drew contact and will go to the line. Coach Brittany Huggins calls Maddie Mandyke the difference maker on her team. And she hits the first. And all of a sudden, they have come all the way back to make this a one possession game. One more for the junior forward. No good. Rebounded by Ladd off to Proietti. 40-37.
Coach D'Angelo is exhorting the girls to push the ball up the court as quickly as possible. They tried to run a couple sets prior to that, and I think in trying to execute or run the set, they just got a little robotic and, you know, out of the flow of what that set was supposed to really do. That happens a lot when a team makes a run like Hall did, and, you know, coach's like, all right, let's run something. And then they get so mechanical and try to just run the set play, they lose sight of how to execute it effectively. Sure. So once they start running, like Hall just did a little while ago, a little bit more success for them. Trick is, can they keep running and keep pressing?
Right. Tatiana misses the first. You know, the shot that she took to get her to the line, second time that she's channeled her inner Kareem Abdul-Jabbar with that skyhook. She hits the second.
It's always nice when you have big kids like the Hall and Conard kids that can finish free throws. Before they're down the end of the game, they throw it inside, they get fouled, and you get a couple the old-fashioned way.
So that ends the 12-0 run. The lead is 4, 41-37. Mandyke shot. No good. Off the back of the rim. Gets her own rebound. Misses a second chance. And here comes Tatiana in a two-on-one. Takes it all the way. Offensive foul called against Conard. They said Reisner got back defensively and held their position.
Yeah, Coach D'Angelo is not liking that call so much because Tatiana's last step was to the side. I don't know. They say that's the toughest call in basketball, the block charge.
Tatiana has four fouls. Venora has four fouls. Haverty has three. So some foul difficulty for Coach D'Angelo.
Yeah, those girls have to play smart, keep people in front of them, not reach, not make any silly mistakes defensively.
Like Mandyke, and she gets fouled on her way into the basket. The Hall foul difficulty, four on Boney, three apiece on Cotter, O'Keefe, and Mandyke.
Yeah, the Chieftains have to, you know, maintain their composure. They did a nice job early on in third quarter when Hall was trying to run offense and just keeping the Hall kids in front of them and not letting them penetrate or cut through the middle. And that time, more and more, the Hall girls are starting to penetrate and sneak in there. So we're going to have to be a little bit more stubborn on defense, the red shirts.
Two of two at the line for Mandyke. She has five, and the lead down to two. 41-39, Conard, with 4.5 to play in regulation time. Here's Poirietti on the drive. Up, misses the shot. Rebound is loose on the floor, controlled by Hall. And the foul's going the other way. So Mandyke got position that time, and the foul goes on Conard.
It looks like it might be on Liz. That could be four on her.
It is
four. So the Chieftains, a little bit of foul trouble or concerns here.
That's the eighth team foul, and a 1-1 for Maddie Mandyke. That's good. And she'll get one more with a chance to tie the game.
Yeah, who would have figured Hall Conard tied in the fourth quarter?
Yeah.
Two great teams like this. That's really the way they should be.
It's fitting. It's absolutely fitting. And the game is tied off a 16-1 run for Hall over the first 4 minutes of this fourth quarter. Here's Poirietti. Back outside to Ladd. Tatiana's three. Too long. Mandyke the rebound. And Hall with a chance to lead for the first time since early in the first half. Mandyke with the left hand into the lane. Her pass is stolen away by Connors. Ahead to Poirietti. All the way. Misses the shot, but O'Keefe fouled her. So there's that Conard backcourt combining defensively, setting up the break, and getting the opportunity at the line in the personal priority.
Great job pushing the ball, but I'm impressed at how quickly Caroline O'Keefe got down there to make a play on defense. She almost came away with a really nice block that time.
So here's Poirietti. First of two, and she rattles it home. Conard in, O'Keefe out for Hall. Nina Poirietti has 5 points on the night. And she hits two of two. She has six. That matches her season average. 43-41 Conard. 3:40 to go in regulation time. This is Van Dyke. Nice move. Up with the shot. It's good. Maddie Van Dyke leaving her defender in the dust that time and ties the game at 43. Tatiana all the way with the shot. Misses it, but she'll go to the line. I guess that's why Coach D'Angelo calls Tatiana a mismatch nightmare. She can beat you from outside. She can dribble drive. She can hit the post up.
Yeah, yeah. She's got a nice little skill set. And again, she's been doing a nice job from the foul line tonight.
And she hits the first. 44-43, 12th point of the night for Tatiana. She and Delaney Connors have combined for 32 of the 44 points for the Chieftains. 2 of 2 at the line, clutch foul shots.
Connor, full court 43. Man-to-man denial. And they're dropping back into man-to-man day.
Here's Reisner all the way with the left hand. It's good, but they're going to wave off the basket. They're going to say the foul is before the shot. It's not going to count.
Yep. I'm not sure. She was kind of flying through there. Most officials might have just given her that one. She got bumped, and she made a great acrobatic finish. Great concentration on her part.
With the left hand.
Yeah, yep.
Brittany Huggins wants an explanation from the official.
Yeah, I'm sure she was assuming that the basket was good. So she gave the ref a hug, had a little talk, and maybe she'll get the next call.
And the first is good. 45-44. That was the 7th point of the night for Reisner. And the second shot, ribs out. Back tap, knocked out of bounds. And Hall basketball.
Well, that ball got tipped around. I'm not sure if the Hall guys didn't about knock that one out. That's the way it goes.
That ball made about 4 rotations around the cylinder.
Yeah,
and just
yeah, that's it.
45-44 Conard. Exactly 3 minutes to play in the contest. Hall with a chance to take the lead.
Reisner wants the ball. Got a great handle, this girl.
3-ball for Reisner. It's short. Rebound underneath.
Going the other way.
And they're going to call Hall on the foul that time. A little too aggressive was Boyle underneath.
Yeah, a little bit. You know, coaches want you to, you know, those are fouls that, you know, if you don't have foul trouble, that coaches are happy about, because keep that ball alive in there, you never know. You might not get the foul, someone puts it back in, and you're doing a great job.
O'Keefe back in, replacing Cotter.
The 76 game ended in Hall winning 48-46.
Wow.
I'm pretty close to that number right now.
A lane violation on the free throw, of all things.
Yeah, Coach D'Angelo is going to need a massage tonight, I think. He's a little stressed out right now. I know how he feels.
45-44, Cotter. 2.5 to go. Reisner for 3. It's off the back of the iron. Rebounded by O'Keefe. Second chance opportunity. Van Dyke in the lane. Misses the shot. Gets her own rebound. But her pass is stolen by Ladd.
Nice hustle by Ladd.
Oh, great anticipation, huh, John? Tatiana for 3. It's good. What a clutch basket that was.
Clutch shot.
48-44.
Yeah, Reisner and Connors have been really kind of, you know, playing offense and defense against each other pretty well. You haven't heard their names being called on the scoring end. Delaney's face guarding a little bit, trying to shut Reisner down. Nice
move by Boyle.
Yes,
that time.
Sweet move.
48-46, 1:45 to go in the fourth. Connors in the lane. Up with the shot, it's good.
Good choice to take her time when she finished that. Looked up, found the defender's arms.
Yeah.
Put it on the glass. Great job.
And that's her first basket of the fourth quarter.
Yeah, yeah.
Minute and a half to go. Two possession basketball game. Hall basketball, they're down four. This is Reisner. Goes for three. It's short, and it's rebounded by Venora. Hands off to Proietti. And Lena walks it across. Expect Conard to be very deliberate here, try to work some clock,
yeah,
I think.
Well, yeah, Coach Huggins got to think of it, almost at 1 minute right now with 4 points. And she might be telling them to foul somebody, and they chose Ladd.
And Liz Ladd, the senior guard, one of the captains on this team.
Yeah, well, now, you know, this much time left, you know, if the gap stays like this, Hall's got a foul, you know, come down and score. You know, Connor's got to make free throws and, you know, that game. So,
oh, sure.
Execution down the stretch here will be interesting for both teams.
And Liz Ladd hits the first. It's 51-46.
Good for Liz. She's had a tough time scoring tonight. Those are big free throws for her team.
Without a doubt. Two of two, 52-46 with a minute to go. And Brittany Huggins off the Hall bench asking for and receiving a timeout. 57.5 seconds to go here in the fourth quarter. The Word Chief Sports Council would like to thank our many fine sponsors, including those at the all-state level. Keating Insurance, MACA Plumbing and Heating, Reed and Reach PC, Counselors at Law, ESPN, the Entertainment and Sports Programming Network, and College Prep Express. Thanks to one and all for your continued patronage of the War Chief Sports Council. So there's Brittany Huggins down below us, diagramming a play.
Yeah.
Is she going to go for a three here, or do you go two if something's open,
you know,
John?
She's definitely got weapons on the perimeter, but they've also taken advantage and taken it to the basket against the Chieftains, really. So, you know, and she's lucky that someone like Delaney Connors and Reisner, they can do either or. She's stepped away and taken a couple jumpers that have just missed, or they may want to throw it to one of their big kids. Connard can't be too aggressive because last year in this situation at Connard, they looked for back cuts early for that early layup. So they might run a set where they try to get an easy basket and then, you know, give it to their best kid let her do her thing. So we'll see.
The other issue for Hall is if they need a quick foul, there are a couple kids with four fouls, so they got to be careful who fouls.
Right. This might benefit Connard defensively if they're, you know, they've got to play a little bit more patiently on defense.
Mandyke with a clutch three. 52-49, a one-possession game, and they immediately foul Poiretti. That was Reisner with the foul. That's only her second. And they'll put Lena at the free throw line.
Yep. I'm not sure if Coach wanted to foul, you know, the foul that far away. She looked like she was a little disappointed. I'm not quite sure. Maybe I'm reading her wrong. And you want to make sure you're fouling the right person,
sure,
in the coach's mind.
Exactly. First one for Eddie is good. Lena with seven on the night. Hits two of two at the line. Two possession game, 54-49, 40 seconds to go as Reisner speeds into the front court for Hall. Dribbles with the right hand.
Good defense by Connors.
Here's Reisner,
yeah,
25 seconds to go.
They're going to try to run stuff through her, it looks like.
Reisner has her shot partially deflected and a foul on the play, and Mike D'Angelo can't believe it.
Yeah, coach's got to be careful. He's already on the court.
Eddie Leidos has to come on the court to restrain him.
Yep, great job by Coach Leidos. It looks like someone got a lot of ball, and then maybe someone else came in. I don't know, maybe hit her. I didn't see that. But the official saw a foul, so we're going to make free throws. Coach has got to keep it together here. I know. I never lost my composure when I coached on, so.
First foul shot is missed by
There's a lot of time in this game. You make a basket here, you get up and, you know, play the fouling game, you get a quick steal or kick it for three. And you know, the 21 seconds is forever.
Misses the second. She, of course, gets three because she was fouled beyond the arc that time. Coach Huggins wants her to make this one so they can set up the press. And she does.
Well, there's one.
54-50. And a timeout being taken with 21 and 110 seconds to go.
Yeah, well, the positives for Conard, obviously, they have the ball and they have a four-point lead. And they know they're going to be coming after them. So they're maybe, you know, some teams like to take the ball and, you know, fake it, a short pass, toss it over the top.
Yeah?
Who knows?
Would you advocate that here?
No. You probably.
But it is a possibility.
It is a possibility. Usually, you know, you want your best hands. You know, you want your hands team, your best free throw shooters in a situation like that. So the kid that catches it and gets fouled right away is going to have a very good shot at making free throws. And then doubling, you know, make sure you don't force the ball. If you're Conard, you know, hold the ball. They're going to foul you.
Right.
You know, don't be too anxious to make a great play.
54-50. Conard with the ball and the lead. 20 seconds to go. Double team in the backcourt. Conard escapes, gets it to Poretti.
One more for a layup.
Up ahead to St. Juice, then she's fouled.
It was maybe a good decision by Tatiana. Venora was down under the basket. Someone was defensively coming back. She maybe could have thrown it, but she didn't. You know, made a good decision to hold it, get fouled. She's been doing a nice job from the line.
Caroline O'Keefe has fouled out of the contest with that last foul. That's a big defensive loss for Hall in the last 13 seconds.
Yeah. On the other hand, too, though, they really got to get after Conard now, you know, up, and then have to push the ball down the floor and try to, you know, pick up the tempo and, you know, score as quickly as they can and or foul as quickly as they can.
So here's Tatiana with 16 points on the night. And she hits the first. There's a calm, cool, and collected customer. Nothing but net on that one.
Yep. Nice stroke. So Connor's probably going to, you know, I don't know whether they're going to three-quarter court, pick them up, you know, try to make them take some time bringing it down and hopefully have them settle for a tough shot.
2 for 2 at the line. She now has 18. 56-50, 13 seconds to go. Reisner, long three. It's short. Rebound underneath by the Warriors. Back outside. Gellerman's shot is deflected. It's loose. Conard has it, and they're going to win this basketball game. Final score tonight, Conard 56, Hall 50, and John Beignet, what a tremendous contest this was.
Tremendous contest. You know, both teams played extremely well. I mean, I don't know that they agreed to that necessarily. I think offensively both teams were a little off tonight. You know, but they've all throughout the game, great individual efforts, you know, great teamwork. They scrapped the whole time. Defensively played very well. I got to tip my hat to the bigs in Hall, at Hall. I thought they did a great job in stymieing Conard pretty much the whole night when they took it to the basket. And then Conard, you know, made a run. You know, they executed, made the free throws down the stretch. It was a really good game. Interesting to watch.
Oh, so much fun. Let's do it again tomorrow afternoon.
Okay.
That sounds
like a lot of fun.
Good.
It was always a pleasure, Pete. Thank you.
My pleasure, John. John Beignet, excellent job as always. Former Conard boys basketball coach for a lot of years. And he watched, as I did tonight, a 56-50 Conard victory over the Hall Warriors. So we're going to come back in a few minutes and hopefully have winning coach Mike D'Angelo and one of his players. Again, the final score tonight, Conard 56 and Hall 50. As always, you're watching West Hartford High School Sports on WHC-TV, Channel 5 and 96, as presented by the War Chief Sports Council.
it's embedded audio, so it should be on the five.
One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Coach Mike D'Angelo, you told me on the phone the other day your signature win was New Britain. I guess now your signature win is the victory against Hall here tonight.
Absolutely. What a great atmosphere. Hall played extremely well. We built a little bit of a comfortable lead. I guess nothing's ever comfortable. This is my first time in this rivalry, so I've learned that nothing's ever comfortable. But I couldn't be more proud of my kids. You know, the way they dug in and got three huge stops and converted on the other end, and then to go 14 for 16 down the stretch at the foul line, you know, it's all you can ask for as a coach, to have them work for 32 minutes and do the best they can, and I couldn't be more proud of them.
Delaney and Tatiana combined for 40 tonight. What jobs they did.
I mean, I'm not surprised. I mean, especially with this one. I mean, every night, night in, night out, she steps up. She goes to the line with all the confidence in the world. She's not afraid of the moment. She's not afraid of the big shot. And I have all the confidence in the world in her that in a time of need, she's going to get a stop, get a rebound, get a steal, or get a big basket. So I'm not surprised in any way whatsoever.
Quickly, let's talk about your season so far. You had 11 years at Trinity. You come here. This is your first campaign, as you just alluded to. 12-1. I know it's only January, but you have to be pleased with the start.
I'm extremely happy. If you would have told me that my first year here we'd be 12-1 and a one-point loss to Glastonbury, I don't know if I would have believed you. The kids have bought into the system. They bought into me and all our coaches. It's really a testament to them and how hard they work and practice every day, the shape that they're in, the fact that Delaney and Lena can play 32 minutes and not miss a beat and still have legs at the end. We got work to do. Like I always tell them, we're a very good team. We're not great yet. We're on our way to being great, though.
Well, congratulations on the win tonight, and best of luck going forward.
Thank you very much.
Delaney, 26-25 game in the third quarter, and then all of a sudden, it became your show. What turned it around? What clicked in for you?
I think it was our defense. Our defense really fuels our offense, and I think we were all together on defense, and it wasn't just me. Everyone on the team really helped. They're always there right next to me. So it was really a great team win, and I'm really proud of us.
Eddie Leidos sent me a stat. He said that you average 15 points a game when you play Hall. Boy, this rivalry brings out the best in you.
I love playing against them. We've played with each other for a long time, and now playing against each other is even better. I guess it's really just the excitement. We have great fans, and they really fuel us. Our bench is great, and we really step up to the challenge.
What's that like to play with kids growing up like you did in youth basketball and to see them around town, and then all of a sudden they're wearing different jerseys on the other side?
It's different. It's definitely weird playing against them after playing with them for so long. We know how they play, which is a little bit of an advantage, but it's great. We're all friends, and then on the court, we're just competing.
Thanks for doing this. You were as great doing this as you were on the floor tonight.
Thank you.
Well, enjoy this one, and best of luck.
Thank you.
Delaney Conard's joining us. What a sensational effort she had tonight. 22 points in the Conard victory. Tatiana St. Just also at 18. What a remarkable start for this Conard team. They're 12-1 on the season. Hall, hey, great start for them as well. They fall to 11-3. Thanks to everybody associated with the broadcast, to Paul and Dennis with the Sports Council, to Meredith, Diana, and Jen from the TV station. They're the ones who make it all possible. We had the pleasure of bringing the game to you tonight, John Benyon and I. And again, the final score for the final time here at Robinson Gymnasium, Conard 56, Hall 50. A reminder, join us again tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock. The boys take center stage right back here at Robinson Gym. Until then, good night, everybody.
We're clear. Woo!